Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is your brother Bilal, inshallah, with a Ramadan reflection, reflecting on recitation and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, I want to share with you all a very powerful verse from the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He opens it up by saying, for each individual, they have an angel that is protecting them by the decree of Allah in front of them and behind them. So what we can tell by this is that the angels are protecting us. And they're also stopping things that aren't meant for us by the decree of Allah. So an example would be you are walking and all of a sudden you have this car just zooms right by you. The angels protected you because if you were to, let's say, have left your house a second earlier, you would have hit that car. But the angels had protected you from that thing that was not meant for you. SubhanAllah. Then Allah says in this verse, He says, and that that Allah will not change the condition of a person until they change what's in themselves. So we can tell by this is a few things. First off is that Allah will not change the condition of an individual. Think about a person that is depressed and they have gone through every single outlet and have done all these things, but nothing is working for them. Think of an individual that wants to get married or wants to have a job and they've gone through every single outlet, but they haven't turned to Allah. They haven't trusted in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They haven't put their faith in Allah. So Allah will not change the condition of a person until they change what's in themselves. Okay? Another way that we can look at this is that if we really want something in our life, we have to be willing to change our mentality and our mindset to achieve it. Think of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, when he is in front of this body of water. He doesn't just sit there and waiting for the condition to change. Rather, he trusts in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he hits the stick on the ground. He acts upon that trust. And Allah opens up bodies of water for us. If we want Allah to open up bodies of water for us, if we want miracles to happen right in front of our eyes, we need to trust in Allah and hit our stick on the ground and Allah will open up those bodies of water for us. But we have to be willing to change, whether it's wanting to have a better relationship with our spouse, but you're not doing any effort to try to change that relationship. Memorizing the Quran, but you are not picking up the Quran, you're not finding a teacher, whatever it is, change the condition so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can change what is going around and make it easy for you to obtain whatever you want. Allah closes this verse by saying that when Allah intends for a person to be ill, there is nothing that can repel it and there is not for that person any helper, any protector except Allah. So the idea is that, you know, if an individual is stricken with some massive illness that no one can cure from it, know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one that can help you. If He can take you to something, He will take you through it. And even if you are ill to the point that you are in chronically, you're going to die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one that can help you. Not just help you, but help your soul. Because that's what is returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect our souls, to allow our souls to return to Allah clean and purified. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the means to change. Jazakallahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.